Barty is the Australian Open champion.
We all cheered Ash's Grand Slam winning performance, but we could just as easily have been celebrating her hitting a six at the G. Ash is one of many stars whose achievements haven't been confined to one sport.
So what you do get with that multi-sport background, if you use Ash Barty as the example, had that early engagement in tennis, which was great at developing those skills, which transferred into a cricket career.
And, of course, back to tennis. According to Jamie Salter from the Australian Institute of Sport, the road to glory begins with diversity rather than railroading a kid into one sport.
Well, sports sampling in its simplest form is allowing the younger generation of athletes to experience a number of sports, so they get that positive growth and development opportunity.
It's a far cry from, if you want to be good at something, just focus on that and keep practicing and practicing and practicing. Well, that did work for Tiger Woods, but it's not the golden rule.
There's certainly not a one-size-fits-all rule. Any development needs to be unique to that individual.
A perfect example would be AFLW superstar Erin Phillips. Before she was kicking goals and taking hangers, she was sinking threes in the WNBA and for the Opals, winning two championships and a silver medal along the way. Young talent Will Sutherland has also had a crack at just about everything.
Swimming, tennis, golf, basketball, everything. That's what all your friends are playing during primary school and going into secondary school.
He eventually narrowed it down to just two sports.
Yeah, I loved cricket in summer and footy in winter and, couldn't separate the two at the time.
Having juggled the two sports for years, Will finally had to make the call.
17, I had to choose between cricket and footy.
Will chose the Willow over the Sharon.
Cricket's been going really well. I've probably played four seasons for Victoria, a little bit of Big Bash cricket as well, and absolutely loving it.
Will's performances have not gone unnoticed. In 2021, he was named the Bradman Young Cricketer of the Year.
Best young cricketer in that year and voted by the players as well, so that was a massive privilege for me, yeah.
With 10 years to go before the Brisbane Olympics, the pressure is already building on Australia's future stars. Rowan Browning, Australia's 100-metre champion, has some wise words for those with big ambitions.
Well, my advice to the parents would be, when you have young athletes, don't push them, just help them build good habits and good structures, and be supportive.
Build that foundation, then start to specialise in the sport that they love or the sport they want to excel in.
Jamie says young athletes like Rowan can also reduce the risk of burnout by playing team sports.
Win, lose or draw, they can get something out of it with their peers. It does add, a reduction in pressure, which means you don't get as much burnout.
I was always a team sports kind of guy. I tried tennis young. I was fairly useless at that. It's a shame because, it's potentially very lucrative. But, I never had the overbearing tennis or golf parent. And I think, that was probably quite crucial to my later development in sport. I fell into the sport because I was good at it at some level. I had a coach who really believed in me and saw potential.
And the flying mullet is definitely living up to that potential.
The first three to qualify, you betcha!
I'm trying to kick this flying mullet moniker. Maybe I need to get it cut, but I'm still liking it. I mean, mullets are everywhere.
Well, mullet or no mullet, the decision on which path to take comes back to the individual.
Ultimately, to be self-motivated, you have to find your own way to something. It has to be your decision. You have to have real ownership over that to be accountable for the results and sacrifices.
Guys, I find this fascinating. I've read a book about this and it starts by comparing Roger Federer to Tiger Woods. As you saw, Tiger then hitting golf balls from when he was three, and Federer, who played a bunch of different sports, soccer, basketball, and then specialised into tennis. And they said when they look at athletes who have gone general first and then specialised, they said you can be just as successful. Tiger reached the top of his sport, as did Federer. But they said, generally speaking, the athletes who have generalised first will be happier. And certainly when you think of examples, like you think of a Tiger Woods or you think of an Agassi, who very famously was forced to play tennis from a very young age, there are very high-profile examples of athletes who have started very young and had very kind of turbulent
And maybe it's to do
lives.
With the burnout and that sense of resentment after a while of, and perhaps the influence of parents around them and
the
obsessional kind of thing.
They said it is, it's also applicable to everybody else's life who isn't an athlete. Mm-hmm. And this book was written before the pandemic, and I thought it was interesting because it said if you generalise first, you obviously learn all these other skills which you can then use in your field, but also it means if something is to happen to your field, you can then just transfer across to another field because you generalise first, which then a pandemic happens and, you know, for a lot of people that would be kind of job saving.
I'm still playing around with the sports yet. Haven't narrowed it down yet.
Well, the Papa hasn't narrowed it down.
Papa hasn't narrowed it down yet.
Okay.
Maybe high jumps next. Anyway, we'll have it on the show next week.